Welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. If you're brand new, but if you're regular, welcome back. So guys, it feels like it's been ages since I did my last video here on the channel, but I'm back now, which is great. And there's something I want to talk to you about, specifically in the topic of finding the best applications for you. Now, of course, here on the channel, what we do is try to distill the best of the productivity applications. What I want to talk about today is how do you go about picking a reliable productivity application? It's hard to distill that because there are so many different factors in that, and there are so many new and older softwares out there. What do you go for, and how do you know which one is best for you, and how do you know which ones are gonna stand the test of time? So in today's video, I wanna give you 7 checklist items that you can go away with. There'll be a PDF below as well, that you can go away with and apply to your next resource pick. You can apply this to productivity software, but also outside of that, even if you wanted to apply it to like web tools or things like that, and it might be of use to you guys. So just before we dive in, I wanted to let you know about the Skillshare course that we've got, Notion Guidebook, which is essentially an overview of how to get started with Notion. You know, I've been talking about it a lot, guys, and also you can sort of create your own dashboard there. So I'm going to include that one in the comments below, in the description below, which you can get access to. So guys, let's start with the first element of the recipe, and that is checking the company's progress. And this sounds a bit weird, but it totally makes sense when you look at it. Now, of course, we all know some applications do have the benefit of being backed by large companies. The likes of Google have Tasks, Google Keep, Gmail, all provided by Google as a service and a free experience. And we have companies like Zoho, who have Zoho Notebooks, which is available, and again, a free service. But it's always good to understand the smaller applications and understand where their company is sort of, how their company is doing as well. So I highly recommend when you get started, checking out their full website, understanding whether there's a company outside of that and whether they provide other successful resources out there. Because once you understand what the company does, you might understand whether they're gonna be reliable, whether they're gonna be staying around for a fair while. So for example, Todoist have obviously their company, Todoist. Todoist also run a Twist application, which is team communication tool. And of course you're gonna rely or be a bit more open to it because it's coming from a reliable source, because Todoist has been out there for a fair while now. So try to think of it like that. Try to approach it in that similar fashion. So the second element of the checklist is social credibility. And social credibility is very important. The best thing to do with this is basically to research your application using social media sites as well. So using the likes of Twitter, Reddit, Facebook, Instagram, search for the name of your resource, learn who's using it, learn whether they've got any feedback, whether they have any huge support problems, and understand the resource feedback in general, because you'll be able to get a bit of credibility around that. Now, of course, you tend just to get sort of like really great ones or really poor ones. So distill the best of the breed, understand whether the resource is for you and whether it's been able to tackle other people's problems. Now, the good way in being able to check this out is use cases, as well as other sites that help compare resource. I know Alternative 2 is a good one, but there are other companies that help you to rank it. And you can look in like some Product Hunt comments and see people's opinions of it too. So number 3 in the checklist is website resources and support, a very important element when you are going into picking that best resource for you. Now, what I recommend doing is when you start, go on the website, have a little exploration around the website, understand whether there are good resources, good FAQs, good help centers that can provide you with the information you need to know so that you don't necessarily have to contact anyone, and also a good support service. You know a good support service when it replies on a regular basis to customers, and also they do something like social media. They'll reply to any tweets, DMs that you send them. But it's always good to understand that you have that network in case you need it. Not to overuse it, but be able to access all of that. Now, good companies that do this are for the likes of Trello, have an amazing blog, have an amazing resource but they also have a great support center. And the likes of Todoist are a good example as well by providing such a strong resource center for you to go and dive into. So number four on the checklist is security statements. Although sometimes we never read those privacy policies, it's important to sometimes. If you're very sensitive about where your data goes and you want a reliable service, you need to be able to understand the best of what a security statement means. And being able to understand where your data is being secured and how it's being secured is very important. Now, because of GDPR, this has become a lot more accessible. So you can find the information on privacy or security or even terms on a website and be able to fully understand how they're using your data. Because obviously that is very, very valuable and important to you. A good example of this is Knotsby, who they do a project management resource. They state they have bank grade security, which is important. And a lot of the other project managers do as well, but it's good to be able to evaluate whether they state anything like this, because security will help you to defend on other items. So number five, paying users. If you are able to determine whether one of your services that you're looking at has paying users, that is good, because you need to understand whether the service offers a premium experience. And I sometimes say it's good that they offer this, because premium shows that they're making income to support their thing. It's okay for companies maybe like Google, where they're gonna get loads of money from other services, or even the likes of Zoho make most of their income from other business tools. But when you're looking at the likes of Todoist, you're looking at the likes of Evernote, you wanna know that they're bringing income in to be able to support the platform. So number six is venture backing. Of course, with the world of startups, there are a lot of funders out there and investors that put a lot of money behind these applications. It's always good to see applications that aren't supported like this. I know that Todoist aren't, and that's something that really strengthened my relationship when I first went about picking them. But I know that the likes of Notion, which I also use, has investors in the company. So it's important to understand whether the company is heavily invested in venture capitalists being involved, if that makes sense. You need to understand if the company, for example, were not doing so well, that the investors won't pull out, and you've got to sort of gain that confidence. There's normally a page on the website called About Us or Company, which might give you some insights. You can also look at a site called Crunchbase if you're getting really nerdy, and be able to see a breakdown of whether they've done seed rounds or investment rounds. But the best resources to go for are normally organically producing money. That's Buffer and Todoist. They're great examples of companies, have a strong ethos, and will, I'm not fully sure on Buffer, but I know Todoist is fully supported organically, which is great. The final and seventh recommendation for you guys is reliable storage. Sometimes it's good to understand, and you can normally find this out in the security or data statements, where your data is being stored. A lot of these companies use other sites, but they sort of embed it in their code. So for example, they may use something like AWS or Google Cloud, that's Amazon Web Services, and Google Cloud as sort of backup resources, or even resources where they host all of the data. So if you're really in detail and you want to understand the reliability of them, you can check there, because sometimes AWS or Google Cloud might go down. I know that AWS had a couple of times last year where it went down and sort of freaked out a lot of people. So it's being able to understand your reliability there if you're really interested in a data element. Anyway guys, those were the recommendations that I have for you when it comes to trusting the resource and picking them out. Of course, it takes a bit of time, so do take your time with that part of stuff. At my own personal experiences, I used Evernote back in the day. That was my first, pretty much my first ever productivity application. And Evernote actually had a breach the year I used it, quite a big one, where all of their data was sort of compromised. And that was quite sort of damaging, I guess, to my confidence with them. But because the company was so big and how much they reinvested in security, I was sort of re-tempted back in, if that makes sense. The likes of Notion, venture capitalist backed. I use them on every single day, but I know that they're making a lot of money from their social proof, as well as from some of the feedback I've gotten from users. So I'm sort of confident about that too. So, of course, it naturally depends on you. Let me know in the comments below what applications you trust, what applications you go for, and maybe some of the parameters that you set when you're looking for a reliable resource. Anyway, guys, a huge thank you for stopping by today. Just before we go, make sure to check out the new deals section. This will be a web link as well, but you can now get deals available in the description. There will be exclusive discounts, comments, prizes, and stuff like that that you can access as well from the most popular productivity brands out there. Now, I'm still accumulating all of those brands there, and the list will get bigger and bigger every time you come to a new video, which is very exciting. So you might be able to win new stuff. You might be able to also get an exclusive discount to one of the services I'm talking about in this video. So do check it out below. Again, I'll include the link there to the Skillshare as well. Anyway, guys, a big thank you for stopping by today. Hopefully this gave you enough insight, and I'll see you in the next video. Anyway, guys, make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.